Hello everyone. So welcome back to our physics class again. So in class 7th we have already discussed two chapters. First chapter was your measurement, where we have talked about how to measure the area, the volume and the density of a substance. Then we have talked about a very important chapter, that is motion, where we have discussed about different types of motion. We have discussed about speed, we have discussed about velocity, we have discussed about acceleration. We have discussed about acceleration due to gravity. Now, today I want to begin with a new chapter, fresh chapter, that is energy. Okay, in class 6, you people must have discussed about work, force, energy. So, we are going to continue the topic so that you can learn the things more in detail. So, before beginning with energy, okay, I want to begin with the topic work. Because work and energy, they are very much related to each other. So, how they are related to each other, we should know. But we were going to understand after discussing about this topic, work. So let us talk about work. So suppose if a person is sitting, watching television. If a person is sitting and writing his homework and notebook, or if a person is sitting and talking to his parents or her parents, in that situation you will say that, okay, I am tired, I have done some amount of work. Or if you are waiting for a person in a bus stop, for your friend, and then you are waiting for half an hour long, you will say I am tired, at least I have done a lot of work today. But in the case of physics, in the language of physics, these are not considered as work. If you are sitting, watching television, got tired, you are writing, completing your homework, got tired, in this situation you say I have done my work. Okay, you have done work, but it's condition, in the case of physics, in the language of physics, this is not said to be work. So what is work? So in the language of physics, if force is applied on an object, if you apply some amount of force on an object and the object changes its position, and applying this force and the object changes its position. So suppose I say my object is kept over here, okay, of 200 Newton, okay, at this point, and a person is applying the force towards this direction. So on applying the force, if the force will be large enough to overcome this force of 200 Newton, in that situation the object will going to shift and the object will going to change its position and will going to move from this place to this place. That means it has covered some distance. So in case of physics, if force is applied to an object and object has actually changed its position, then you will say work is done. So if a chair is kept somewhere and you have picked that chair and placed it somewhere, some other place, then in this situation you can say yes, you have done some amount of work. So in physics, what is work? If force is applied on an object and the object changes its position, then work is said to be done. And the formula of work is force into displacement. Formula of work is force into displacement, means how much amount of force you have applied and how much the body has actually displaced from its position. The body has shifted from its position. So this product is known as work. Now, SI unit of work, when we talk about the standard unit of work, the SI unit of work is joule. So the question comes, what is 1 joule of work? Or how much, what is actually 1 joule of work? So what is 1 joule of work? When a force of 1 Newton is applied, when a force of 1 Newton is applied in an object and the object changes its position by 1 meter. Okay, so if there is one object of weight 1 Newton, suppose, so if you apply the force of 1 Newton, minimum force you apply is 1 Newton, and on applying this force of 1 Newton, the body changes its position by 1 meter. Then in this condition, you will say 1 joule of work is done. So in which condition the 1 joule of work is done? When the force of 1 Newton is applied and the body changes its position by 1 meter. Under this condition you can say that one joule of work is done. So work depends upon two factors. What are those factors? First factor is force and second factor is displacement. So this is the thing you have to remember about work. Now we are going to talk about more thing about work, that is under which condition no work is done, what are the factors which affects the work and all those things. So as I have discussed condition when the work is done, when you apply a force on the body and the body actually changes its position, then you can say that work is done. But what is the condition when no work is done? Okay, so in physics, no work is done when an object or a body does not change its position on applying force. So if you apply a force, so whatever amount of force you want to apply, you apply on an object does not change its position. Like suppose if I take a very simple example of a car, okay, you apply full of your energy in terms of pushing that car, or in terms of that you want to raise that car to a height, but you have not succeeded. You cannot raise a car to a height because it is a very heavy object. Or you want to shift a truck, you apply force on the truck, but the truck does not shift it from its position, does not move at all from its position. In this situation, you have applied force, no matter how much amount of force you apply, but still the body has not changed its position. So you will say that the work done is zero. So one very simple example is pushing a ball. So suppose a ball is there and you started applying force on the ball and you want to push that ball. Is it possible to shift the ball from one place to another place? No. Since the ball is not shifting, that means you have applied force and the body has to move. So suppose you have applied the force of 1000 Newton, okay? You have applied the force of 1000 Newton and does that ball shift it from its position? You will say no. So how much displacement the body has shown? The body has shown a displacement of 0 meter. So you have applied the force of 1000 Newton, but the body is actually shifted 0 meter. Means it has not shifted from its position. 1000 into 0 will become 0. So how much amount of work is done? 0. No work is said to be done. One more very simple example. Suppose a passenger is standing stationary. Stationary means in a rest position and carrying suitcase in his hand. Or suppose you are standing somewhere waiting for your friend and you are carrying a very heavy bag on your shoulders. In this situation, you are not moving from one place to another place. And still you are carrying some bag or any object in your body. In this case, since the movement is not being done, since the body is not moving from one place to another place, you will again say that the work done is zero. So these are the two simple conditions when no work is said to be. Then the work done is dependent upon two factors, that is force and displacement. If any of the thing is zero, in this situation, the overall work will also become zero. So these are the two situations which will tell you that work done is zero or no work done. No work is being done. So since we have understood what is work, in what condition the work will be done, and under what condition the work will not be done, I want to discuss one numerical, and remember the formula of work, that is force into displacement or force into distance. So numerical is here, a force of 5 Newton when applied to a body displaces it 2.5 meter. So you have applied the force of how much Newton? 5 Newton, and the body has got displaced by how much meter? 2.5 meter. Simple, two things are given, that is force is also given and displacement is also given. Find the amount of work done in this process. So for solution, first you will note down what is given. What is given first in force? How much force is 5 Newton? And displacement. Displacement I will denote it by S. Okay, displacement I will denote it by S. So I will write displacement. Denote by S, which is equals to 2.5 meter. So we are having force also, we are having displacement also. F, force I will denote by F. So please remember, I am denoting force by F and denoting displacement by S. Formula of work, force into displacement, or in short form F into S. So So how much work is done? How much is force? 5 newton into displacement 2.5 meter. 2.5 into 5 will become 12.5 newton meter, that is equals to joule. So how much work is actually done? 12.5 joule of work has been done when 5 newton of force was applied. Here one more simple numerical is there which is dependent upon work, which I want to discuss, but I want two people to please solve and show the solution to me. A man lifts a brick of mass 5 kg. Okay, so you have to note down this question and you people have to solve of your own. I'm just discussing the question. So a man is there who is lifting a brick of how much mass? 5 kg mass. So mass is given from the floor to a shelf of 2 meter high, and height is given 2 meter. So up to a distance of how much displacement the brick has done? 2 meter displacement. How much work is done? Simple, you have to apply the formula of work and then you can be able to solve this question when you are to use the formula of work. Okay, since we have discussed about work and what are the conditions when the work is set to be done, we are going to start with the main topic of the chapter, that is energy. So this chapter will basically depend upon energy, types of energy, and many things are there. So let us begin with the topic energy. So before beginning with this definition of energy, first thing I want to discuss that whenever you do some amount of work, okay, whenever you are performing any kind of work, in that situation, you are using energy to complete that work. For example, suppose you want to go to play football. Okay, so before going to or before you are starting with the game, before you want to start with playing football, your body is full of energy. But as you start playing football, after slowly and slowly you will start losing your energy, and the time will come when you will get exhausted, you will feel tired because you have lost all the energy which was present with you. Why? Because in that condition, while playing football, you were running from one place to another for chasing football, and you were running and dribbling the ball and all those things. In that condition, what has happened? Your body has lost energy. So to perform any kind of activity, to perform any kind of work, you actually require energy. So when you proceed with that work, your body keeps on losing energy. So in the initial level, in the initial stage, at the starting, your body is full of energy. So when body is full of energy, at that situation, we have just started work. Okay, work has been started. Now, as the energy will be lost, you will keep on losing energy. In that situation, the amount of work done will be more. So, more amount of work you have to do, you have to lose more amount of energy. So, energy and work are actually related to each other. To perform any kind of work, you require energy. And when you lose energy, then only in that situation, the work done will be more. Now, to a certain amount of work, energy is required. We use energy to do certain amount of work. While doing that work, our body loses energy and we get tired. So this is the condition happens. So what is energy? Energy means capacity or ability of doing work. If you are having that amount of energy to complete that task, to complete that work, you can complete that work with the help of your energy. So if I ask you to go and shift that truck from one place to another place, in this situation you will not be able to shift because your body does not have that much amount of energy. So whatever amount of ability you are having, whatever amount of capability you are having to perform some work, that will be considered as your energy. So what is energy? Capacity or ability of doing work. And while performing any work, what is being used? Energy is being used. Since work and energy are related to each other, the units are also similar. So when we talk about unit of energy, energy is measured in two units. It can be measured in joules or it can be measured in calories also. So joules, the SI unit of energy is basically joule. SI unit of work is also joule and SI unit of energy is also joule. So both are having same units because they are related to each other. But when we use calories as a unit, so calories is used as a unit of heat energy. So whenever you are relating the type of energy is heat energy. In that situation, you will always measure it in condition of calories. For example, your food products. In that condition, the amount of energy which will be produced by those food products will be always measured in calories. So whenever you buy any food product, eating items like chips or whatever you want to buy, in that situation, when you look behind the packet, you will find that the amount of energy it will produce or it will carry is given in the terms of calories. So heat energy is measured in terms of calories. So joule and calories also related to each other. And basically the SI unit of energy is joule. So these things you have to learn. Now about the units, about their units, the relationship, you can say that 1 calorie is equals to 4.184 joules, or in simple terms 4.2 joules. So each calorie, 1 calorie consists of how many joules of energy? 4.184 joules of energy. So this relation you have to learn. In higher classes sometimes we use 4.2 joules also, but the more accurate value is 4.184 joules. So 1 calorie, it consists of 4.184 joules of energy, and basically calories is used in terms of heat energy. So this is the topic about energy you have to learn, so that we can proceed with more topics related to energy and types of energy and so on. And we will discuss some numericals also, so which are very important. So you have to learn the formulas also of one topic.